Like the video or I'll wake up from a 5-year coma and give your waifu a legal smooch in the mouth.
Part 2. Verdant Wind. Ethereal Moon. Reunion at Dawn.
It sucks. This map sucks. I know. I just had this thing in the last episode where I was like, this is the turning point where the maps are going to become a lot better. And I still believe that from what I remember playing, but this map is not great. Though, there are some good design elements in play here that are meant to give a specific type of challenge to the player that I can appreciate. The map is covered head to toe with tight corridors and forest tiles. This is probably the most forest tiles we've ever interacted with in the game so far. Your movement is substantially limited, so you're kind of nudged into the direction of wanting to use the mini choke points as you push through the map. It does make things a little slower, but I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing in a Fire Emblem map, if there is enough to do in each turn that holds your attention. And I feel the amount of enemies presented is serviceable. Plus, you still have your flyers to help pick up the pace. The enemy assortment here feels really good, like they were actually designed to take better advantage of the map than the player units. The enemy types mostly consist of snipers, sword users, and fisters. The snipers have long range, letting them shoot over the terrain instead of having to move slowly through it, and it keeps the flyers in check. Most of the sword users have pass, which let them ignore the terrain and easily pass through the choke points, letting them feast on the squishy units. And both the sword and fist units are faster than almost all of your units could be. Yes, I know, in the last chapter I forgot how to remember things, how I thought that the AS of the Demon Beast was 38, I looked and remembered the wrong stat, and I even remembered the wrong number. I know, I'm dumb, but I checked, and then I checked again, and I checked 3 more times, and I checked 12 more times. They are super duper faster than any of your units beyond like a Pegasus Petra or something. My point is that the enemy has a lot of general advantages that the players have to overcome. A challenge, if you will. But this map still sucks. Basically, no matter how they designed the map, no matter what gimmick or enemies they threw at you, this map was going to suck. And that is all due to the restrictions the game places on the player. You are not allowed to customize anything about your characters before starting this map. Whatever weapons, abilities, classes, battalions they had in the last chapter, they have now. Aside from the Lord who gets a special class promotion relic weapon. Maybe I wanted Hilda to be an armored knight. She's not going to hit too many enemies being an axe-focused flying unit against so many sword users in the forest. She might make better use soaking up damage, trying to draw on enemies to take them out. If I was given the option, I would have made Leonie switch off of Paladin to go back to Pegasus Knight. Letting her fly over all the terrain while still maintaining a weapon triangle advantage would have been great. What if I had someone in off class that I was just training up their class rank level to get their mastery skill in the last chapter because I didn't think they were doing anything? You don't know. I don't know. It could happen and then you'd just be stuck with them. I could burn down the forest with a blaze gambit, or you know, equip Swordbreaker on my units. I thought it wasn't that useful in the last chapter, there weren't a lot of sword guys. I just kind of left it off, but now I don't have it. Great, fantastic, awesome. Imagine if I could get my stride gambit for my dancer Sylvain who can't be deployed this chapter because he's not a base Golden Deer student. Imagine. This gets doubly annoying when all of your units are sent into pre-deployed locations that spawn at later turns in the chapter, and you can't change who goes where, which means you can't plan or set up synergistic teams. You just have to go with what they give you and let it rock. My main healer, Marianne, and my main magic user, Lysithia, were placed on the other side of the map. Both of these are things that I'd like to have in my main force, thank you. Meanwhile, Lorenz and Ignatz are placed together in a little corner that I basically have to rescue them from because they just get one-rounded and neither can kill a unit on their own because they're Lorenz and Ignatz, weaker support type units, they're bad. And what if you aren't using some of these units? Like, you never trained them, ever. Yet they were force deployed and they're just a hindrance to the team at this point. All of this makes it hard to formulate an effective strategy. Everything the game tries teaching the player about planning synergistic combinations and strategies is just chucked out the window for this map. I get the story reasons, it makes sense why it is, how it is, but all this really does for gameplay is make you play slower. You couldn't change your crew how you wanted. You had no say where people were. Everyone was split up. You just had to slowly inch forward and complete what ends up feeling like a route map. even though the objective is defeat the boss. I will say though, I thought it was cute how you had to beat the boss twice. And both times I played this map, he caught me by surprise. First, not knowing that he would do that at all, the second time by not knowing he appears on the side with the least amount of allies. But flying units are busted and they hunted him down easily. 3 out of 10.